Alright, so first and foremost, I want to give all praises to the Most High Yahweh, Hashem Yahushai, the dominance of the apostles and elders of great notes in the world, and salutations to the Archimedes and the Christian who don't know truth and sincerity, day in and day out, breaking on the strongholds, dividing the lies from the truth, to say Shalom. Right? And this is one of the brothers from GMS Trinidad East, which is one of the camps in Trinidad and Tobago. My name is Rai, and hey, it's just a little insight on the scriptures, you know, plus just to add onto the Israel versus Christianity, to put it in that term, right, to bring a little light onto is Israel, right, the Bible speaking about, and it's Israelites, who the Mosai of Hashem Yahushai is coming to see. So this Isaiah 8 verse 10, it says, take counsel together and it shall come to naught. It says, speak the word, it shall not stand, for God is with us. So yeah, so we speak in his word, and Christianity wouldn't stand. The doctrine that they be bringing out wouldn't stand. Just as the way, just the way you can see it by how they trying to fight us at the moment, right? So that, so let's remember that this Isaiah 8 verse 10, it says, take counsel together, it shall come to naught, right? It says, speak the word, and that's what we do. We speak the word in season, out of season, constantly bringing out this truth, straight of the Bible, from the old and from the new. That we say, speak this word. We just speak half of it and teach another half. We speak the whole thing. So, it says, speak the word, it shall not stand. Yes, all these strongholds like Christianity, Roman Catholic, all these sort of things, so it wouldn't stand. The doctrine wouldn't stand because I am a dead. We speak any word, right? I'm doing these videos, I'm going out on the streets, you know, prophesying, and we speaking this word. It's the most Yahweh, Yahweh shares with us. So everything that come against us, it wouldn't stand, or everything that come against us, it wouldn't stand, right? So it say, speak the word, and it shall not stand, for God is with us, right? Yeah, so, you know, all these doctrines that we've been, all the hell doctrines and all these lies about the one Antichrist and it's not only Israel, it's Israel hypocrisy, right? Blasphemy, all these things, because at the end of the day, the Bible clearly states it's for the Israelites. No, we speak in this word, right? Let me see if I got a scripture here quick before I mention that, right? Is 2 Corinthians 10 verse 4. It says, for the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty through God to the pulling down strongholds. Yes, so this the things we speak and the breakdowns we do, it mighty through God, through power, right? Now bringing on these strongholds, bringing on these strongholds like Christianity and so on. Right, bringing on the doctrines, bringing on the lies that they be teaching. But it's because, going back to Isaiah 8 verse 10, it's because we speak the word, of the Most High. So we're doing that, as it said. These things, it wouldn't stand because we're speaking the truth. Right? Just as the prophets before, the lies couldn't stand because they was doing what? They were speaking this word. Right? Now, some questions, you know, matter of fact, not even questions. They suppose something outside it is Revelation 21 verse 12, because they're saying it's only for say anybody got called on the name, which you all don't have the name, because Jesus is not the name, right? Could be saved, and you don't need to be of the 12 tribes to be saved. No, if it's one of the things that they speak constantly, it's heaven, about heaven, and everybody entering those gates. No, this is Revelation 21 verse 12, it says, and had a wall great and high, right? Let's see, and had 12 gates, and the gates 12 angels, right? And names written their own, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel, right? So if you're talking about those gates, right, and all these things, so what Revelation 21 verse 12 talking about, you know? Let's see, and the gates 12 angels and names written their own, and the names written their own, which are the names of the 12 tribes of the children of Israel, right? So we're talking about, okay, clearly state on the clearly state the names that were written there on was the names of the 12 tribes of Israel. But you all talk about heaven and all these things. So how you go and go into that kingdom? How you gonna meet the Mosai if you're not of Israel? Right? How you gonna be with him? How you gonna rule with him if you're not of Israel? I'm saying you all talk about heaven and going through those gates, but your Edomites can't go through those gates. Okay, it's in the 12 tribes. Right? Elamites, Ishmaelites, whatever, they want to not of it, of the 12 tribes, then who are you going to be there? Right? They can't go. They can't go. Right? They can't enter. Right? And the reason why I'm going to skip is just to show you, hey, the 12 tribes was mentioned even down to Revelation, which is something all I love to go into, but have no understanding of, right? This is Revelation 7, I'll just go straight to the point. This is Revelation 7, verse 4, right? Let's see. I heard the number of them which were sealed, and they were sealed 144,000 of all the tribes of children of Israel. So them that are going to be sealed is had to be of Israel. It can't be of nothing else. Right? It can't be of nothing else. It has to be of the 12 tribes of Israel. And it's mentioned here even in the New Testament. Whether you like it or not, it's written. So if this is going to be 144,000 of the 12 tribes of Israel, because not all Israel is going to be caught up, right? All Israel is going to be saved, but they're not going to rule with the Mosai. Some of them have to get destroyed as well. In 2/3, I go back to the Old Testament. Let's say 2/3 going to be cut off, right? So if you're not up there, so going down to Revelation 7, you will see it even mentioned the tribes of Asher, the tribes of Judah, tribe of Simeon, and going down, right? Now you come and say in the heaven and say everybody, then what about this? What about the seal? Because in this Christianity church, I believe for the past year was the highest, right, of any other religion to have people in it. Right, which is millions, right? Which is millions, could be billions, right? Because, and if it's just 144,000, how they in seal yet? Or why they in seal yet? You know, how the Mosai come back yet if it's so much of all yet? Yeah, because we know it's an elect, a certain among the Mosai dealing with, and it's an elect of Israel, which is 144,000 and 1/2, right? Because if it have billions of people on this place, in this Christianity, how the Messiah come back here to redeem all here? Why he didn't come back here? Okay, see, the world had to reach the four corners of the world, right? Which is the correct doctrine that reach the four corners. But if you watch all the earth is right now, you have a church at every corner, right? You have a church at every corner. You have a pastor, a Christianity at every corner. No, if that was the right doctrine, then Holy Messiah ain't come yet. The Christianity was the right doctrine. Holy Messiah ain't come yet. Which, that is not the right doctrine. Right? Because then the world would have done reach four corners already, because Christianity all over. It don't have a country that don't have Christianity. Or any other sort of religion. Now the right doctrine would be what we teach. What the men of GMS teach. Right? Coming on from the apostles and the elders going straight down. Right, the 12 tribes, just as I read here, right? When I bring on the Revelation 21, just to show those gates, and what was written on those gates, which was the 12 tribes of Israel, and Revelation 7, talk about the 12 tribes, the 144,000 of the 12 tribes, right? And it's just to show you how these people, how Christianity had people messed up. Basically, it's just a business, right? People want to be saved, but if your name not written, then they're not going to be saved, because everything is predestined already from the beginning. Right? This is Acts. This is Acts 26, verse 6. Let's see, verse 6, right? They say, and now I stand and am judged for the hope of the promise made of God unto our fathers. So who the promise was to? These Christians are sure can answer that. Who the promise was to? The promise was unto the Israelites, right? You see, the promise was unto the seed. It was unto Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, right? You see, the seven. It says unto which promise? It says unto which promise? Our 12 tribes instantly, our 12 tribes. So why would Paul, right? Why would Paul be talking about these things? Right? Why would Paul be mentioning unto which promise our 12 tribes instantly serving God day and night hope to come? Why would he say that? Because it was only for the 12 tribes of Israel. Right? Y'all don't get it because you're blind. And Christianity only caught up. Right, but this book was written to the 12 tribes of Israel, which is the Negroes, Latinos, and Natives, according to the same word. Right, it says, "And night hope to come, for which hope's sake, King Agrippa, I am accused of the Jews." Right, but just going back, it says, "Unto which promise our 12 tribes?" Now, does Paul saying that? This is Luke 22, chapter 22, verse 30. I'll start from verse 29. It says, And I appoint unto you a kingdom, as my father had appointed unto me, and ye may eat and drink at my table in my kingdom, and sit on thrones judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Why they didn't say Christianity? Why they didn't say everybody? Why they knew how should I say everybody? Right? Why? We don't even understand the kingdom. Right? But it's just a show that, hey, 12 tribes was written all over this world. The tribe was written all over, the new, the old, no matter what they like, no matter what they say, no matter how you try to dodge it. Right? This Bible was written to the 12 tribes of Israel. And for them, and the promises and salvation is for Israel, as John 4 says, salvation is for the Jews, right? Which is the Negroes, Latinos, and Natives, right? So you know, just hey, I just want to show, to prove, or to show, right, that the church was written all over the Bible, old, new, and salvation is sudden. They said, hey, straight out. Understand? You know, to all the Christians, only Roman Catholics, or whoever, they lost, totally lost, right? So, you know, with that, we give all praises to the Most High, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushai, we say, Dominance to the Apostles and Elders of Great Moses, Medulway, a teacher of truth and continue teaching the truth to the Ankem on today, pushing the word on truth and sincerity day in, day out, constantly pushing us word in season, out of season, and some rest in the life. To get to come out of here, right? To wake up the elect of Israel, we say Shalom, right? Till next time, we say Shalom.